What is up, everybody? Welcome back. And today we are going to be talking about the possibility of a bundle when it comes to Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, and Modern Warfare 4. Things are starting to ramp up and get a little heated when it comes to COD 2019. What is going to happen? What is not going to happen? We're about at that time frame between February and I would say April where you start to see little things leaked. Most of it isn't exactly true. And what we're going to talk about today, well, I'll get into the disclaimers of it in a second. The gameplay you're watching is some Black Ops 3 gameplay from Darian Aaron, and I'll put a link to his Twitter. If you guys want to submit your gameplay for a chance to be on the video, the link is in the description as well. And I need you guys to do me a favor. At the top of the description is my Twitch channel. You heard me right. I'm blowing the dust off of my Twitch channel after 4 years and making a comeback on March 1st. So get over there and give it a follow. There's going to be a ton of live streams, Call of Duty, Apex Legends, Fortnite, everything throughout 2019. And now we're going to talk about some more alleged leaks. And here's, I want to give you guys all the disclaimers up front. This is probably not true, okay? It cannot be confirmed, and there is no validity to it in the form of being able to have confirmation. It wasn't leaked by a highly rated leaker like we've seen in the past with Shinobi or other people like that. It was literally put on Reddit, and then the Reddit user deleted his account, but the post is still there. But the reason I want to talk about it is because even if he made it up out of the cloud, out of his head, there's some stuff that actually makes sense. This is an article over on Dexterdo.com, and they even say, it should be noted from the outset, this is a highly dubious source with little to verify their claims, and even if it was genuine insider information, all of that is subject to change. So I need to be crystal clear with you guys, none of this is confirmed in any way, but some of the points I'm going to make from this article, you're probably going to shake your head up and down and be like, you know what? That actually might make sense, which means it's a good topic for conversation. All right, we're going to go through this article together as you guys watch this gameplay on the video. So, yes, Activision has confirmed that there is an upcoming game for Call of Duty, duh, and it will include a single-player campaign, a large multiplayer mode, and a co-op experience. Well, the first thing we gravitated towards with the large multiplayer mode sentence was Battle Royale. Well, not according to this leak. So we know for a fact we're getting campaign. Campaign is going to be coming back, and we're going to get some new kind of co-op experience. The leaker, who said that they left the Q&A team at Treyarch due to being treated poorly, they claim to have talked to other Q&A testers at Activision Infinity Ward, and this is where they got their information. So once again, this is all completely alleged. Take it with a grain of salt, all right? They confirm the name of the game is Modern Warfare 4. I mean, I confirm that myself. I think it's going to be Modern Warfare 4. I think it totally makes sense. I think Infinity Ward needs something that people can attach to from the past during the glory days, and this is the way to do it. They say that, we're going to give this leaker a name. We are going to call this leaker Bob, all right? So Bob says that the campaigns from Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 remastered will be available on launch with Modern Warfare 4. Says the multiplayer portions of the game may come later, but the leaker claims that Activision doesn't want to split the player base immediately. Now, let's stop right there before we get into all this other stuff. That kind of makes sense if you think about it. If they gave us Modern Warfare 4 and they gave us MW2 and MW3 remastered campaigns to go right along with Modern Warfare 4, that kind of makes sense. And then you don't put in multiplayer till later because you don't want to split that player base at launch. You want everybody to be focused on Modern Warfare 4. But for people that like the offline single player campaign action, that would be cool. Play Modern Warfare 2, play Modern Warfare 3. You are totally set up with the storyline for Modern Warfare 4. Now let's get into some really interesting stuff. Okay, like I said, their Reddit account has been deleted, but the post is still there. I'm not going to put anything on the screen. We're just going to verbally talk about this. Some of the highlight points from the post included Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3 campaigns. We said that. no specialist. Raven Studios, working on a mode similar to War Mode from Call of Duty World War II and helping with the new co-op survival mode. This all makes sense to me as well. Raven Studios is a great support studio when it comes to Call of Duty. Heck, they're a great just lead studio. I think Raven Studios should get a shot at their own Call of Duty title, if you ask me. I've been there twice, and the staff and the developers and everybody there are nothing short of amazing. No Battle Royale mode. That is a new one, okay? But if we break it down for a second and think about it, it kind of makes sense. Why would you make another Battle Royale mode if you already have Blackout? Then you would split your player base even more. That doesn't mean, even if the leak is true that there is no BR mode, that there isn't a new map to go into Blackout, which could be Whiteout, Modern Warfare 4, whatever. It could be its own map where it's all of your old school Modern Warfare points of location, points of interest, characters, all that stuff. So that's still in play, okay? Here is the here's the spin. Modern Warfare campaign to be set before Modern Warfare 2. Now, I had never thought about this. I thought about Modern Warfare campaign. How can you bring back the classic heroes? Price. Well, Price is still alive. But how do you bring back Soap? And how do you take advantage of Ghost and the popularity and the love for all of those heroes? Well, you do flashbacks, kind of like the Black Ops series has done, right? Or you completely throw that out the window and you go for a prequel. They were all alive. All of them. I mean, Sandman, Ghost, Price, Soap. We can even go back to McTavish being alive, people. This makes a lot of sense, and it actually gets me pretty excited. I want it to be true because I want the campaign to be set before Modern Warfare 2, where they're all still doing their thing. I think that is absolutely brilliant if it's true. Infected search and rescue gun game available at launch. Tactical nuke returning will not end objective game modes. And pro perks. Does anybody remember pro perks? Pro perks returning. Now, we're going to go into some more about this article. Bob said, I had a wild post over on the Black Ops 4 sub, but it was deleted. Basically, I worked at Q&A and quit 2 weeks ago due to how Treyarch treated us. Why would you say that, though? They can literally track down when you worked there if you did. Anyway, take this with a grain of salt. He said he got this from other QA testers. Modern Warfare is the name, or Modern Warfare 4 is the name. We get that, right? Supply drops are still there, unfortunately, but it's the same system as Infinite Warfare's. DLC model is different from Black Ops 4. It'll be 15 maps for the pass, with free maps rolling out throughout the lifecycle. Free monthly COD points, DLC weapons go to season pass holders for free access to the beta content, new maps, war maps, extra login bonus, 4 special character costumes. Was also being talked about releasing all maps for free and having no DLC pass, but a cheaper pass, which included everything except for the above maps, would be free. A mode like World War II's War Mode, which will be developed by Raven and will launch with 3 base maps for it, and they're different in a way as to war. Was war popular? It was cool when we first saw it, but then didn't it kind of fizzle out? I didn't really enjoy it. I don't know. We'll have to see. Customization-wise, camos, but the interesting part is the character customization. You can change your head accessories, your beanie, hats, helmets, torso, shirts, vest, legs, feet, kind of like Advanced Warfare, it sounds like. Absolutely 100% guarantee from Bob himself, no specialist in the terms of BO3, IW, and BO4. Think Modern Warfare 3 type specialist. Okay, he's saying maybe some strike packages. I don't know. Killstreaks are similar to MW2, MW3. Plenty of original guns. No Battle Royale. It was obviously being talked about seeing the success of Blackout, but Activision wanted to keep building on it, but the player base has dropped drastically since January, even more so after the release of Apex Legends. Campaign is set before Modern Warfare 2's events, and that's all he said he knows about the campaign. We'll have co-op play and a camo reward system for playing to encourage people to play. We'll have keys like IW to unlock supply drops, but we'll also reward 1 to 3 random players after every single match like World War II. The new co-op mode is a survival-based mode, but it's more like an open world. Think Battle Royale type, huge maps. You will have level progression for certain unlocks, guns, and attachments. And the objective is to kill, collect certain things, and it will have a skill tree system. It's being worked on by Raven with Infinity Ward. Will come with 1 map at launch, as far as I know, with the plans releasing 1 map every other month. Now, the last time I heard anything about the mode, it was early, so a lot could have changed. Maybe that's their new version of Battle Royale. I don't know. Now, multiplayer modes. The usuals are returning. Infected on launch with Search and Rescue. Also, Gun Game Wager matches for Keys, Demolition, and more. Continuous stream of content over the year. Different from Black Ops 4. Instead of tiers, you just have to complete challenges for rewards. Example is kill 100 players with X gun to unlock Y gun, so on and so forth. Tac Nuke is returning, but will not end objective-based modes. Campaign is set to be 7 to 8 hours long, and pro perks will return. Now, this is all from Bob. Okay, that doesn't exist anymore because Bob deleted his account, and it could all completely be fake. But the reason I wanted to talk with you guys about it is because even if it is fake, there's a lot of stuff in here that makes a lot of sense, and I kind of hope happens with Call of Duty 2019. And obviously, Activision sees what's happening with the shift, with Fortnite, with Apex Legends, with the free-to-play games, with the constant updates and content, and they are going to have to adapt to that in one way or another, or they're going to sink. That's how it is. So you guys, let me know what you think. It was a super interesting leak. It sucks because you can't really connect it to anybody with any viable history of leaking, but it was still fun to talk about. Let me know what you took out of this. Drop a like, guys, and I'll see you soon.